New person, forgotten name, awkward moment, studying for an exam all night, panic and defeat, learning a new language, forgot the words. Information, data, words, faces, numbers, appointments, so many things to remember.
So how can we deal with it? How can we aggregate this plethora of information efficiently? And why does it take so much repetition to memorize something? Wouldn't it be splendid if we could just memorize something in an instant? Let's go and find it out once and for all.
If there's anybody who knows something about memory, it's a memory champion. Memory champions are able to memorize thousands of digits, poetry, names, books, anything in a mind-boggling amount of time and for a ridiculously long period, even forever.
But do you think they are superhumans? Do they have special inborn abilities? Well, let's investigate their brains.
Now, if we take a brain of an ordinary person and that of a memory champion, which differences would we be able to attest? Perhaps the size, you might think. Well, no. In reality, the sizes are generally the same regardless of your memory bank's capacity. The IQ? No. Interestingly, there is no substantial correlation between IQ and memory. To tell you the truth, the difference lies in a swollen hippocampus in the brain of a memory champion.
And here is the crucial point. The hippocampus increases in size only during memory exercises. That is, everybody, you, me, any world memory champion have generally the same starting point.
There is no trickery in what I do, no special effects or electronic aids. I just sat down one day and decided that enough was enough. I was going to train my memory. Dominic O'Brien, 8 times world memory champion. But still, hippocampus, the part of the brain responsible for spatial orientation and data deciphering.
Somewhat confusing, isn't it? What does spatial orientation have to do with incredible feats of memory? But wait, if you actually think about it, it makes perfect sense.
Have you ever wondered how easy it is for us to remember locations? Put differently, how many locations have you been to since your very birth? Your room, house, school, class, camps, parks, friends' house, city, streets, and so on. That is thousands, tens of thousands, and maybe even more locations. And most interestingly, somehow, no matter what, unless you were a bit merry, you could easily recall the appearance of these places. Remember your old school friend's room many years ago? I bet you still do. And if I show you now 5 different numbers and then escort you to 5 different rooms, you would find recalling the rooms much easier.
If you really think about it, every single human, you, me, and the rest are geniuses for visual memory. And now, we're very close to solving the riddle.
If memory champions and ordinary people initially have comparable brains, and both categories have incredible visual memories, the conclusion is that the memory champions are somehow using visual memories to encode and decipher information. Makes sense. The enlarged hippocampus.
So how can we finally solve the problem of forgetting? Memory palaces.
Memory palaces is what differentiates an ordinary person from a mnemonic juggernaut. Also known as the method of Loci, memory palace is a technique purportedly conceived in ancient Greece. It was commonly used to deliver hour-long speeches and memorize vast amounts of verses. It was even taught in schools, until the church banned it in the 16th century. With memory palaces, committing any sort of data to your memory is feasible. But how does it actually work? How to achieve results in an effective and a reasonable amount of time? Look, if you step into your room and you see a whale, are you ever going to forget that? Doubtfully. Why? Because it occurs in a real room, while the presence of a whale is amazing. Plus, you have something incredible happening in real conditions, much more memorable than just seeing a random person there, since it's too ordinary. Now, if you have a set of information difficult to memorize, here's what you do. You convert it into something tangible, something you can imagine, feel, touch, or smell. 2, you put it into a location you're familiar with.
The more bizarre the imagination is, the more senses it employs, the less the chances are that you'll ever forget it.
Now, let's memorize the first 10 digits of pi. We're going to use the most primitive technique, but it should give you a good idea of the process. First, convert the data into something tangible. One looks like a spear. Second, choose a location. For instance, the route you take every day: bedroom, toilet, kitchen, lobby, stairs, etc. It is, however, crucial that you put these images in a sequence and that the rows do not intersect to avoid confusion. And now, create. Imagine you wake up in your bed when you realize that you're surrounded by aborigines with spears closing in on you, willing to hunt you. Immediately, you run away to the toilet. Now, four looks like a yacht sail. Imagine you step into the toilet to realize that it's flooded and that a real yacht with sailors on it are sailing through your toilet. You should be able to proceed with the rest of the numbers in a similar manner. Remember, make the information tangible. Put it into a real location, ensure that it follows a sequence. And the next time you wish to recall the sequence, simply play the scene in your head again. As simple as that. Now, I know this might sound a bit odd, but it really works. What's remarkable is that the same logic applies to poetry, books, manuals, and anything you wish to assimilate. If you wish to have a to-do list or a schedule, pick a 7-station route corresponding to the 7 days of a week and put things there reminding you of your appointments. If your goal is to remember everybody's names at a conference or in a class, there are plenty of ways to do it by using memory palaces. For instance, I studied civil and construction engineering, and memorizing data about various building materials has never been easier. I simply put the study material into rooms and corridors of a university. Sort of a knowledge bank inside your head that doesn't let any information out unless it is your desire.
And see you next time.